Welcome to Solving Quadratic Equations Using Square Roots. We'll be solving equations in the form of ax squared plus c equals 0. This is a very specific form where there's no x term. And we'll be solving these equations using the square root property, which states that the equation u squared equals d, where d is greater than 0, has exactly two solutions, where u is equal to the square root of d and u is equal to the negative square root of d. And sometimes this is written as u equals plus or minus the square root of d. So what this is trying to tell us is if we had u squared equals 36, then u would equal positive square root of 36, which is 6, and u would also equal negative square root of 36, which is equal to negative 6. Remember, if we square negative 6, we still get positive 36. So we'll have a positive and a negative solution. And notice that if d is negative or less than 0, there are still two solutions. It's just now that we have imaginary solutions. Let's go ahead and take a look at some examples. So even though number 1 is factorable as a difference of squares, we're going to go ahead and solve this using the square root property. So let's go ahead and add 9 to both sides. So we'll have x squared equals 9. Now if we have x squared and we want x, we can take the square root of both sides of the equation, as long as we remember to include a plus or minus to obtain the two solutions. So we have x equals plus or minus the square root of 9, which is 3. And if we wanted to, we can list this as x equals 3 and x equals negative 3. But often you'll see the answer written in this form to represent both solutions. Okay, and number 2, notice this is not factorable because we have a sum of squares. But we can use the square root property to solve this. So we'll subtract 64 on both sides. So we have x squared equals negative 64. Now to get x from x squared, we'll take the square root of both sides. And again, plus or minus. So we'll have x equals plus or minus the square root of negative 1 times 64. Well, the square root of negative 1 would be I. The square root of 64 would be 8. So we have x equals plus or minus 8i, or x equals 8i, and x equals negative 8i. Let's go and take a look at a couple more of these. Okay, and number 3, again, we're trying to isolate the x squared, so we'll add 64 to both sides. So we have 2x squared equals 64. Now, in order to isolate the x squared, we still have to divide by 2 in this problem. So we'll have x squared equals 32. And now we can square root both sides of the equation, plus or minus there. So we have x equals plus or minus the square root of 32. But 32 is equal to 16 times 2. 16 is a perfect square. So we have x equals plus or minus 4 square root 2. And let's take a look at one more. Again, we need to isolate the x squared first, so we'll go ahead and subtract 7 on both sides. So we have 3x squared equals negative 7. Now we need to divide by 3. So we have x squared equals negative 7/3. Now we'll square root both sides of the equation. And there's our two solutions. So we have x equals plus or minus. Remember, we can't leave a fraction underneath the square root, so we could rewrite this as square root negative 7 over square root 3. But now we can't have a square root in our denominator, so we'll multiply the denominator and the numerator by square root 3. So we'll have x equals plus or minus square root of, well, this would be negative 21 or negative 1 times 21 all over the square root of 3 times 3. So we're going to have plus or minus I square root 21 all over 3. Again, notice we have a positive and a negative solution. Okay, I hope you found this video helpful. Thank you for watching.